am Ramya Hitchcock, Department of Physics, KV Society, S. Nijlingappa and Independent PU College. Today we are demonstrating an experiment called focal length of the convex lens. Before going into the experiment, let us look at some of the terminologies associated with this experiment. So, we will define lens. So, lens is a refracting medium bounded by two surfaces. So, we can see this is the convex lens. Convex lens is nothing but a converging lens, which is thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges. I'll repeat, convex lens is a converging lens, which is thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges. As you can see the ray diagram here, we'll define optic center. So, this is the optic center. It is a point on the principal axis. So, it is a point on the principal axis. The ray passing through it goes undeviated. Optic center is a point on the principal axis. The ray passing through it goes undeviated. After knowing what is optic center, let us discuss what is focal length. Focal length is nothing but a distance from the center of lens to one of the foci is known as focal length. The distance from one of the center, that is O, to one of the foci is known as focal length of the convex lens. As we studied some of the terminologies, let us look into the aim of this experiment. The aim of this experiment goes like this. Determination of focal length of convex lens by plotting a graph of u versus v. Here u represents the object distance and v represents the image distance. So we will look into the principle of this experiment. The object distance must be greater than the focal length of convex lens to get real and inverted image. Here the real image is nothing but the image that can be caught on the screen is said to be a real image. So the second principle is, when object distance is equal to twice the focal length of the convex lens, then the image will be equal to twice the focal length. As we studied aim and principle of this experiment, let us look into the formula associated with this experiment. So the formula F is equal to OA plus OB divided by 4. Here OA represents the image distance and OB represents the object distance. We measure the focal length of the convex lens in terms of centimeter. So the SI unit of focal length is centimeter. After studying formula, let us look into the ray diagram. So this is the ray diagram. As you can see, this is the lens. This is the convex lens we are using. And here O represents the optic center. And we have P1, that is object pin. And P2, that is image pin. And we have focal length F and 12. The distance from the center of the lens to object pin is known as object distance. I'll repeat again, the distance from the center of lens to the object pin is known as object distance, that is represented as u. The distance from center of lens to the image pin, P2, is known as image distance. The distance from center of lens to the image pin is known as image distance. Image distance is represented as v. As we studied aim, principle, formula and diagram, let us look into the apparatus we are using in this experiment. Okay, this is the apparatus we are using in the convex lens experiment. As you can see, this is the optical bench. This is the optical bench and we are having a lens stand where we are going to place convex lens. So this is the lens stand and we have two pins here. As you can see, we are using two pins. One will take it as object P, that is P1, and other one will take it as P2, that is image P. So for noting down the readings, we are using a centimeter scale, as you can see. Now we will find the rough focal length of this convex lens by distant object method. So we have to find the focal length of the convex lens by using a distant object method. So we have placed convex lens in the lens stand. We'll focus for some distant object. So we'll focus for some distant object to get image on the screen. So as you can see the image obtained on the screen. So the image obtained on the screen is real and inverted. We'll measure the distance from center of the lens to the screen and we'll note down rough focal length of the convex lens. So the rough focal length of the convex lens is found to be 10.2. The rough focal length of the convex lens by using distant object method is 10.2. So the next part of the experiment. Now we have placed an object pin P1 here. As you can see, this is an object pin P1 and we have to keep the lens, that is convex lens, between F and 2F. As you know, the rough focal length of this convex lens is around 10.5. We have to keep the lens between F and 2F. So we have kept an object pin P1 and we have kept lens between F and 2F. So we will focus the object pin P1 such that we have to get real and inverted image. As you can see, you are getting real and inverted image of an object pin P1. You can see the object pin P1, right? Now we are placing a pin P2, that is an image pin. Now we have placed an image pin P2. We'll adjust it for P2 such that P1 is adjusted such that it tip coincide with the tip of the image without parallax. So we have to adjust P2 to get coincide with P1. So we'll adjust by moving to and fro. Now you can see the image pin P2. The pin P1 exactly coincide with the image pin P2. You can see here, you can see in the lens. That is, P1 is exactly coinciding with P2. So we have parallax. Parallax is nothing but apparent shift in the position of an object. So when you move to your right and when you move to your left, you can see both the pins are not moving together. So we have to remove the parallax by moving the image pin P2 so that there should be no parallax. So we'll adjust for image pin P2 such that there should be no parallax. Now you can see we have removed the parallax. As you can see, we have removed the parallax. You can move to your right and left
both the image pin P2 and image of the lens moving together. As you can see, the image pin P2 and image moving together, so there is no parallax. So we'll note the distance between convex lens to the image pin and convex lens to the object pin, and we'll write it as object distance u in centimeter and image pin v in centimeters. So this is the tabular column we are having. So f is equal to 10.5 centimeter. The focal length of the convex lens is 10.5 centimeter by distant object method. We found the focal length of the convex lens by distant object method, and it is found to be f is equal to 10.5 centimeter. So we have trial number here, and object distance should be measured in centimeter, and image distance is measured in centimeter. So the object distance is nothing but a distance from the object pin P1 to the center of the lens. So the object distance is nothing but distance from the object pin P1 to the center of lens. We'll take it as object distance. So we'll take it as object distance. So we'll calculate image distance. Image distance is nothing but the distance from the center of lens to the image pin. Distance from the center of lens to the image pin is taken as image distance. We'll note the value of image distance here. Okay, so we'll note the object distance value and image distance in centimeter. So we have to do up to 5 trials. We'll take 5 trials for object distance. Correspondingly, we measure the image distance in centimeter. As you can see, this is the sample of the graph for the focal length of convex lens. We have taken u along x-axis, that is object distance along the x-axis, and image distance v along the y-axis, and we have plotted the graph for points. So we got the curvature like this. As you can see, we got the curvature at exactly 45 degree. We have cutted the curve, so you can see we got the straight line. So the distance in the x-axis, that is the object distance, we'll measure it as OB, and image distance we'll measure it as OA. As we already know, the focal length formula, f is equal to OA plus OB divided by 4. We have to calculate this distance, OA plus OB divided by 4. The focal length of the convex lens OA plus OB divided by 4 will get some value in terms of centimeter. So the result of this experiment, the result of the focal length of convex lens should be in terms of centimeter. We can calculate from the graph as I shown you the before. I hope this experiment is useful to everyone. Thank you.